Hi, boys and girls, it's Miss Debbie. I hope you've had a great week. For your older kids, we're going to be in Acts chapter 13 and 14 if you'd like to follow along. But today we're going to be learning about Paul and Barnabas and the journey that they've taken. Have you guys ever taken a trip? This is a map of the United States. And this is where we live in Tennessee. The reason I'm showing you this map is because of this next map. This is a map that shows you where Paul and Barnabas traveled to on their first missionary journey. Now, Paul, or Saul, was in Antioch with the church there. But he felt that he was being called to do something different, that the Lord was sending him and another disciple named Barnabas out to do something a little bit different. They were going to go out and preach to the Gentiles as well as the Jews. This was different because some of the Jews didn't think that the Gentiles should hear this message, but Paul and Barnabas knew that God was calling them to do that. So they headed out from the church in Antioch where Paul had been and planned a journey to Lystra. When they got to Lystra, they saw a man that had been born unable to walk, and Paul felt moved with compassion and healed the man. This made the people of Lystra amazed, and they believed that Paul and Barnabas were gods and began to worship them. That upset Paul and Barnabas, and they tore their clothes and told them no, that they weren't gods, that they wanted to share the good news of Christ with them. Well, that was wonderful, and people believed. But about that time, some people came from other cities that Paul and Barnabas had been in previously, from Iconia and from Antioch, and they started to stir up trouble. They started to make the people of Lystra not like Paul and Barnabas. In fact, it got so bad that they stoned Paul and they dragged him out of the city. They believed he was dead. But the believers in the city of Lystra gathered around Paul, and Paul was able to rise. And the next day they headed out to a different city called Derbe. While they were there, they shared their good news with the Jews and with the Gentiles, and many people believed. But Paul and Barnabas felt called that they were supposed to go back to Lystra and to Iconium and to share with the believers, to encourage those that were already there and believed, to help set up the church in a better way. They felt that, like we as all Christians should, they should be spreading the good news to people, that they should be telling people about Jesus Christ. In fact, our big picture question is, what should we do as Christians? And that's the answer. We should go and make disciples of all of the nations. That's why I showed you the map, is because I want you to understand that no matter where we are, we're supposed to be sharing the good news of Jesus Christ. Now, Paul and Barnabas, they were grown-ups. They weren't kids. But did you know that you can share the good news of Jesus Christ in your school, with your friends outside? You can tell lots of people about Jesus. The Bible tells us we were called to do this, and I have faith that you can. Now, for those of you that come into Miss Debbie's class, second grade and under, we're going to be making a map this week to go on our keychain. Do y'all remember this? Hopefully you still have it. The last time I taught, we made a lamb because it was Easter and we're going to remember Jesus. And this week we have our map. If you guys can't make it and you're watching this and your mom and dad want to send me an email, I will be glad to send them a shrinky dink. I hope you guys have a wonderful week. And remember, wherever you go, you can share the good news of Jesus.